Everyone. In 14 September 2015, our planet Earth was exposed to a gravity wave stream, causing it to deform in the frequency shown in the following clip. What really happened on that day? To find out, let us leave our planet Earth with its charming moon and travel far, far away to a distant galaxy, 1.4 billion light years away, and at a moment 1.4 billion years in the past. We just reached to witness two black holes orbiting each other. One is 35 times the mass of the Sun, and the other equals 30 Sun's mass. As they near each other, their speed increases and they are causing ripples in space-time fabric each round. The moment they merged took 0.2 seconds. They turned into a single black hole of 62 sun masses. The remaining three suns' mass converted into gravitational waves that literally shocked the universe, spreading in expanding spheres across the universe at the speed of light. They distorted every star and planet they met. The three suns' mass emitted during the immersion of the two black holes produced energy during 0.2 seconds that can be simply calculated. Power equal energy divided time. Energy equal mc squared, where m is the mass of the three suns and c is the speed of light. This equals to an overwhelming 2.7 multiplied 10 to the power of 48 watts, 10 and 48 zeros to the right of it. This vast energy was 50 times more than the light emitted by all stars in the visible universe combined. But why we didn't feel these waves on that day in 2015? The reason is, the effect of these waves after traveling 1.4 billion light years was so tiny, in the range of 1 divided 1,000th the size of a proton. In this simulation, we look to an enlarged hydrogen atom. We have to zoom so deep to see the detected deformation in the space-time fabric. The deformation is presented by the movement of the proton surface shown, in the range of 4 multiplied 10 to the power of minus 18 meters. If the deformation was so small, how we could measure it? The answer comes from LIGO, the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. It took us almost 100 years since Einstein predicted the gravitational waves to build the technology capable to detect such tiny deformations. Two observatories located in Hanford, Washington, and Livingston, Louisiana, were built from 1994 to 2002. Each observatory consists of two arms 4 kilometers each. The laser light is generated and divided between both arms. Then reflected on the mirror at each arm end to be directed again to the detector unit. Any slight change in the length between path A and path B would result in a change of the laser wave interference pattern that can be detected. The accuracy of this setup is 1 divided by 10,000th of a proton. This is equivalent to measuring the distance from Earth to the nearest star, Proxima Centauri, at 4.25 light years away, with an error less than a human hair width. How many gravitational waves observatories do we have now? In addition to the two LIGO observatories in the USA, there is the GEO 600 in Germany and Virgo in Italy. In Japan, there is the Kagra, and in India, there is the LIGO India planned to complete by 2024. Having more gravitational wave observatories in different places around the globe allows scientists to locate faster the locations and sources of gravitational waves coming from space and direct our gamma rays telescopes early enough to collect valuable and rare data about the source. Last episode, Elias O managed to predict the subject of this episode. Many thanks for your involvement and interaction. Thanks for watching and see you next episode.